I'm in the little tiny little TV in the corner of the picture to give you a little video about what it's like to have a hit video on YouTube, which I do right now with the original BINA-VIEW video, which many of you may have already seen. And because this is the first video I've had in a number of years that has really gone anywhere, and because of the new analytics and everything, I thought it'd be interesting to look just at the numbers and the data of this video and maybe try and unravel some of the secret sauce, if it's possible, of how to get a hit video. Now, the last time I had a really big hit video was with the NemoTube video. It was quite a number of years ago, but with this BINA-VIEW video, I now have analytics, and so thought we'd take a look here at this is the graph of how the BINA-VIEW video has been doing over the past 11 days. It's been up for 11 days. It's kind of hard to see, but this line down here, this little gray line, that is my average YouTube video curve. You can hardly even see it above the baseline there, but that faint gray line, that is my average YouTube video. And the blue line is the BINA-VIEW video, the first one I put up. Very, very different. And as of, you know, today, 189,000 plus views. Typical in this period is 5.3K to 8.6K views. So yeah, that's quite a big difference. And this is the little chart that I put it up on the community page, but this is like after the first day. So this is day one here, and this really sharp curve, you know, out of, you know, it sort of went through the first 24 hours and started flattening off, and then, you know, at the 24 hour mark, it just took off vertically again. And and a couple days later, this is 2.5 days in, again, you see another upturn here at the end of the second 24-hour period. And this is where I knew that I had a video that was going to take off outside of my regular subscribership. Again, here's the typical video performance down here in the gray. And it's kind of interesting that at the end of every 24-hour period, I would have this dramatic uptick, and it would start to take off again. And so I put this up on the community page, and people commented, you know, quite rightly, oh, what you're looking at there is just, you know, people are falling asleep and people are getting up in the morning and everything. Well, I mean, that's true, but if that were the case, if that were the case for all my videos, then the same kind of, you know, step-tiered viewership would occur in the average performance, but it doesn't. I mean, in the average performance, you can see it's pretty much took, you know, after the first 24 hours, it's pretty much flattened out, and it really doesn't get many more views, the average video. Because typically, any video I put up after 24 hours, maybe 30 hours, pretty much everyone in the subscribership who's going to watch it has watched it, and it really just kind of flattens out. And for most every video I put up, after 24 hours or 48 hours, the videos really don't get many more views. It's pretty much just goes flat line, just as this gray line indicates. But this particular video didn't do that. At the end of every 24-hour period, it had an upsurge and it would be pushed again. And so this is the signature of a video that is going to be going interplanetary and leaving the orbit of your usual subscribership. So. But that, it's an interesting signature. This is the follow-up video, the BINA-VIEW repair, and again showing, this is the blue line here, that's my, that's the actual views, and this gray line down here, that is my typical performance. Interesting thing about the follow-up, I released this follow-up video just a couple days after the first one, or maybe 3 days after. Again, although the views are greatly elevated for the BINA-VIEW repair, this curve is not untypical. It is basically the same curve that I'd have for a regular video, more or less. But you notice in the first couple of days here, you don't have that dramatic step-tiered uptake like you had on the first video. This is the signature of a video that is riding the coattails of a viral video and being dragged along with it. But the performance of this video, although highly amplified, is much more typical. It has a much more regular curve than that first BINA-VIEW video. Okay, so this is after 11 days. This shot was taken today. And it shows very interestingly that right here at the end of day 10, again, this is there's 24-hour cycles. At the very end of day 10 of the run of the BINA-VIEW video, the first one, you can see here it just stopped coming up on suggested videos, and also the performance here, for the browse features, you see here these big surges that were happening every day up until the end of the 10th day, and then at the end of the 10th day, it's just not coming up and surging in browse features, and it's no longer coming up in the suggested videos. So at the end of day 10, the run was over, and YouTube, again, this is looking into the mind of the algorithm, the end of the 10th day, it's just my video just got pulled off the shelf, the run was over. So very, very interesting. It really did seem to follow, I mean, if just looking at the raw data, it really did seem to follow 24-hour cycles. And after 10 days, it just seemed to be turned off. Could be, you know, any number of factors for that, but it just did seem like a very nice round number for the video to just kind of just fall off its interplanetary trip at the end of day 10. Interesting too, though, this is the other part of it. These are the top 10 videos as of today for the past week. And, you know, the BINA-VIEW video, first video is number one, the follow-up video is number two, the BINA-VIEW crawl is number three, and tagging along the NimoTube, again, because I had referenced that in the first video, and it also is my most watched video of all time on my channel, so it's being dragged along in number four. The interesting thing is that out of all of the videos on this list, the one that's being dragged up that is completely like out of context is the fifth most watched video on my channel right now, which is that video from January 2013 of "Stop watching these videos, don't you know Fran is ... This is the other thing about the algorithm. That video, that specific video, is the one video that is brought up to the front of the queue every time that I have a successful video. It doesn't matter what it is. That video, YouTube takes that video and puts it up to recommend to just about everybody if I have a hit video. It happened with the NimoTube, it happened with my eviction video that got a lot of views, it happens with my popular rants. Whenever I have a popular video, YouTube takes that video, the "Stop Watching These Videos" video, and puts that one back up in the front of the queue, even though it's from January 2013. So it's not that I mind that video being seen, because I have that video up because I want it to be there if people want to see it. But that video was one of five videos that I made between like 2011 and 2013 that were topicked about trans issues. And I've the other four videos I have delisted. They're still up there, and you can see them on links from my blog page where it's more relevant. But I had to delist those other four videos, because if I hadn't delisted them, then every time that because I found this out when the NimoTube took off in 2017, that all of those videos get pushed to the top of the queue and get suggested. So if I didn't delist the other four videos, then five of the top 10 videos right now would be all those trans videos. And this is another thing about the YouTube algorithm. It's not that that video is relevant to the BINA-VIEW. It's not that it's on topic to the BINA-VIEW, like the NimoTube is relevant and on topic. It's because that video is the most trolled video in my catalog, and it has had the most negative response, and it has had the most positive response. It's just, it has caused the most outrage and controversy. Yeah. So yeah, this is what I mean. Here's the video performance for stop watching these videos. This is typical viewership, you know, to what I would expect after 7 years. And then of course I have the first BINA-VIEW video here, and then the second BINA-VIEW video there, and then the third one there, and doom 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 doom. There you go. Google keeps dragging it up and up and up, and it's just being churned up in the wake of popular videos. So. It is also that video that caused me to curate my channel, because that video has gotten so much trolling that I've had to go and, you know, start bouncing off comments. And so that videos like that, certain videos are curated. So, you know, people who come to attack me based on a video like that, or want to put, trolling comments, or want to, say something pretty vicious about me. My views on free speech are, you have free speech, you can say whatever you want on your own soapbox, that's your channel. But if you come to my channel, you're in my house, and it doesn't mean that I have to have you stand in front of me and scream in my face in my living room. No. So, you know, if you want to criticize me, if you want to insult me, if you want to do whatever, do that on your own channel. You don't come here in my house. And so I have to delete more comments on that video than any other video, which is why I have the other ones delisted, because I don't want to curate them all. And so people might say, well, Fran, why don't you delist that one and you won't have to worry about it? Well, because I gotta have it up. I have to have that video up. It's like the reason I made that video is because if I don't have that video up, then, you know, it's the punching bag. I have to have that video to be the punching bag for my channel, so that people who are going to rage at me rage there, and then I just get rid of them. It's like the flypaper for trolls for the whole channel. The video itself says that this is why people want to troll me, is because of this one thing. Well, there are people who say that I should, you know, I should be saying that at the beginning of every video I make, or I'm a liar and a blah, 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 blah. It's one of the biggest, most vocal criticisms of the people who want to criticize that particular video are that, well, I should have that like tattooed on my face, because if I didn't, then I'm being evil. You know, if I didn't have like that video, like superimposed over every video, that I'm being evil. But it's there. But YouTube puts that video up on the top of the list. But YouTube puts that video up on the top of the list whenever I have a hit video. It's been that way for 7 years, so I don't expect that it'll ever change. But it's, again, another look into the mind of the Google bot, that controversy and negative comments are just as highly prized as something that people actually like. So there you go. This is the channel overall. It says, looking good. Your channel's views are up 734% due to more interest in several of your videos. And we're just really talking about those three videos. And here we go. Took in the last 28 days, 529,000 views, which is 322,000 more than usual. Watch time is up. About double, and I gained a bunch of subscribers, which was good, because my channel had been pretty much getting net zero subscribers all year up until at least since January. It had been getting like pretty much like net zero subscribers, so channel needed a bit of a kick in the pants to remain relevant and survive through 2020. So I'm just glad that I was able to get, you know, hit one video out of the park. But videos like this are very rare. I very rarely get a video that gets, you know, more than 100,000 views. Like I said, other than the original NimmoTube video, which has done better than any video on my platform, the only other videos that have really done well and really gotten outside my subscribership have been my rants. So again, that goes against the criticism. Some people said, you know, people don't really complain now, but years ago when I started doing rants, people were complaining all the time that, oh, Fran, you know, this is why your channel's going in the toilet, because you're doing rants. But it But when I would show time and time again that the rant videos would get like 5 times or 10 times the number of views that my average video for projects would get, it just showed that, you know, no, my rant videos were, you know, for years, the only videos that were actually getting out of the channel. But even though, you know, this video has gotten almost 190,000 views today, we're probably over that right now, in 11 days, for my channel, that is a huge, like, interplanetary video. But, like, for my peers, like the other e-YouTubers, that's like peanuts, you know? So, I mean, my channel is a teeny tiny little channel in the e-YouTubers world. And so even though the BINA-VIEW is, you know, done really well, it's going to hit like 200,000 views. I mean, for like Electro Boom, if Electro Boom had a video that only got 200,000 views in 11 days, it would probably be at like the bottom of the list. It wouldn't even hit like the top 20, you know, of that week. It's just such a huge difference between my teeny little channel and the kind of audience that I can reach with my material and those of my, you know, peers. My channel, I've been, you know, doing this for 10 years, about. Other people, I think Dave Jones, I don't know if Clive has published data, but I know Dave Jones has on numerous occasions published his data on his channel analytics and such. But what little I know of my peers' video channels, their channels have very like linear growth, where you could look at when they started the channel, where it ended the channel, and it's pretty much like a steady growth line. And all of my, the other YouTubers, they, all those channels are at least 4, 5, or 10 times bigger than mine, even though we've all been doing it for about the same amount of time. And unlike my peers that have like very linear growth, the growth of my channel is very tiered, where, you know, for years and years, no growth, and then I'll have a hit video, and then I'll get like a huge jump in my subscribership and sponsorship, and then it'll flatten off for like another 6 months, a year or something. I'll have another hit video, and it'll shoot up, and I'll get another big jump in viewership and subscribership, and then it'll level off. And so, you know, in my channel, you get this, you know, step-tiered, long periods of like no growth, and then like short periods of like rapid growth, and then long periods of no growth. And that's what my channel's like. So it's very, very different. The dynamics of my channel, how it grows, and the kind of people that get to see my videos and how my videos are shared, it's very different for my channel than even my other e-YouTubers. And, you know, it's hard to say why. Obviously, one thing to point out is that, you know, my channel has just got such varied content. You know, I've got, you know, electronic stuff and commentary and music stuff and art stuff and other explorations. And so it's not one specific thing. And I, you know, as a host of a channel, I am obviously a sort of an acquired taste. Not everyone likes the pace at which I talk, and not everyone likes the look of my face and the cut of my jib and such. So it's not like I have a presentation that's wildly popular or really rings with people. And my videos tend to be quite long, and not really short and really heavily edited. And I don't have like fancy graphics, and I don't have like beautiful photography necessarily in my channel. So yeah, I mean, lots of things you could, you know, sort of consider. But that's about it for this one. I just wanted to give you a little insight, at least as much insight as I can have, into having a popular video. You know, a lot of people are going to comment, anyone who's still watching, probably comment about the, you know, the Veritasium video that was done, like, oh, what was that, a year ago now? Where he went through like his super viral video. But that video that he was talking about really was a viral video. It had like millions of views. I've never had anything like that. But for me, you know, at least going interplanetary, just sort of outside of my usual orbit, the BINA-VIEW video certainly meets those criteria. And I, you know, the thumbnail certainly had some to do with it. I think this is a really banging thumbnail. But, you know, I gotta say, in the last like 6 months, a year, I've had some pretty good thumbnails that I've worked hard to kind of, you know, get just right. And a lot of those videos, well, pretty much all those videos really went nowhere. So I can't really contribute to any one thing. But one thing is for certain, my channel has depended on these sorts of breakout videos for many years. Without them, if I can't get a breakout video at least every year, my channel would be dead. So having at least one video that gets anywhere near like this number of views, like 200,000, it's sort of, for a little channel like mine to survive, it's like a home run. But I have the satisfaction of knowing that this one video will keep the channel afloat at least for another 6 months. And so I've got some time to come up with another good one to knock out of the park. But it's something that at least every year I have to have a decently popular video. Otherwise, YouTube will stop circulating my videos altogether. I've talked about this a lot, but it's just riding that algorithm. If you don't have a wildly popular video on a somewhat regular basis, then YouTube will shelve your channel, as it has done mine many times. And hopefully this BINA-VIEW video will keep my channel going into the summer and give me another chance to do something, you know, really good and come up with another good video to maybe get my channel into 2021. So thanks, everybody. Thanks for watching. Thanks to all the patrons down there on the Patreon for keeping this channel going. For a channel as small as mine, I've got an incredibly loyal sponsorship with the people who support this channel on Patreon. I'm very grateful for that. It's the one thing about this channel that is very unusual is the amount of support that I get for the size of the channel. And I'm very grateful to everyone on Patreon for keeping this channel going. That's it for this one. I'm Fran. I'll be back, well, not here on the screen, in the screen world, but I'll be over there in the other room at the bench real soon. Bye! That's where I work. Berserk in my lab, it's where I work. At the bench again.